Welcome to the Three Retro Movie Geek Podcast with me, Rob Taylor.
Me, Scott Witham.
Me, Paul Constable.
What's that? Welcome to the Three Retro Movie Geeks Podcast with me, Rob, the Truffle Shuffle Taylor.
And me, Scott, I ain't got time to bleed with them.
And me, Paul, Safe Cocktail Constable.
And we're going to be talking about 80s and 90s movies from our childhood.
The greatest cinema era ever.
Dylan! You son of a bitch.
What's the matter? The CIA got you pushing too many pencils.
Mary Brown, Uncle John, he claimed he had the music, but he had a lot of fun. Oh, baby, yeah.
Knock, baby. Knock. Hello, and welcome to our first 87
to discuss Predator. Joining me once again are not two, but three goddamn sexual tyrannosauruses. Tyrannosauri, that'd be. It's Paul. If it please, we can kill it, Constable. Our guest joining us once again is Mark Get to the Chopper Parzo.
Very good.
And last but not least, he's been waiting 11 months for this. It's Scott. Hold a minute. You've been shot. You're bleeding, man.
I ain't got time to bleed.
With him. That's good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Very good.
Thank you. Right. Welcome
I suppose
back.
You had the Christmas break to think of them.
Yeah, I had 8 weeks. I didn't this morning. Right, we're discussing Predator. Welcome back, Mark.
Thank you.
Did you enjoy your last...
Loved it, yeah. Die Hard, obviously.
Yeah. Good fun, wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah, it was good fun, wasn't it? He loved it, didn't he?
I did. Yeah. All my friends.
Yeah.
All three of them. They actually listened as well.
That's good. That's a three more listeners.
Just a quickie. Is Arnold joining us on the intro? You got anyone to... I mean, I got Devore last time. I mean, is anyone helping out with the intro?
I'm in talks with him. See if he can do an intro.
We asked him, but he charged too much.
Yeah. It was like £100,000 or something, so...
Not worth it?
No, so thought they're not... right, okay, we've got lots to get through today, but before we do, is everyone well?
Yes.
Watched any 80s movies?
90s, I'm going through 100 movies, it's not 100 80s movies, it's 100 greatest movies, apparently, scratch thing, so what have I been picking up recently? Blade Runner, that was an 80s movie, I've seen that before.
Yeah.
Science of the Lambs, again, watched it as a kid, rewatched that, enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I would.
Yeah, that's good.
Airplane, all these things apparently on this 100.
Yeah, I always so, Airplane every day.
So
well.
I'm scratching these off slowly but surely. That's me, that's mine.
Do you know what I watch every day I've never seen before?
What?
Rain Man.
What?
Oh, never seen
no
Rain
way,
Man.
No way, you're joking.
I have
Jesus.
Rob, I mean, come on, you're doing an 80s podcast, you've never seen Rain Man.
You're joking. Oh,
it didn't appeal to me when I was younger. There's no monsters in it, was there? There's no aliens, there's no sci-fi.
It's about serious.
It's about real
life
stuff.
I love Rain Man.
I have seen it, but I can't remember most of it. I just remember the gambling scene. That's all I really remember.
Yeah, it was good, eh?
I remember buying it at it wasn't Blockbuster, it was probably ripped video back then. They used to have two copies side by side, and it was one of these, when the films first came out on VHS, you could buy it simultaneously at the same time release, and it had like a little thing on the top saying rental or
purchase,
and you had to pick up the right one because there was a big price difference between the two. So I've had it since it came out, and I mean that's a classic. Dustin Hoffman, oh my god.
Yeah, it was really good as well, but when I was younger it didn't really appeal to me.
Times.
No aliens, no robots, no monsters.
No back in time, no space.
Back in time, yeah.
The only thing that was dated with that film that I felt is the Lamborghini Countach.
Right.
I mean, at the time, I used to love it. I had a picture on my bedroom wall. Yeah. I think they're hideous.
Yeah. Oh, I like the old 80s supercars. They're
classics, aren't they?
Well, I like the old 80s supercars. I mean, my Austin Metro, classic. You remember that past, don't you?
Yeah.
Nice. What colour?
It was like a dark burgundy brown colour, wasn't it?
Okay, classic. Sounds really good.
It was nice.
Sounds fast. That burgundy metro, was it fast?
Burgundy.
That was your black metro.
Oh, it's my mum's, really.
Was it? Yeah. How did you go on with your mum's black mini metro?
Oh, very good.
What's its corner handling like?
Very good.
Yeah?
Yeah. I had a red
we'll leave it at that then, shall we, Paz?
I had a Red Rover Metro GTI.
Mrs. Paz, though, if you're listening.
GTI. Yeah. Everyone loved those three letters when you were like about 15, 16.
Yeah.
GTI.
GTI is cool, isn't it?
Yeah, like SR Nova, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, the Nova, the Vauxhall Nova.
Right, anyway, this isn't Top Gear, is
it? Welcome to the Top Gear podcast.
I'm not Jeremy Clarkson.
I tell you what.
You
do look a bit like Jeremy Clarkson.
I tell you what, Robert, you know diddly squat.
Right. That was good.
Thank you.
Right, okay.
I'm here for the next hour, unfortunately.
I hope so, because it's all your equipment.
Well, yeah. And my recording studio.
Yeah, and you got lock up. Right, Predator. Scott and Mark, I think it's your favourite film, isn't it?
Favourite film.
I think so, yeah.
Rewatching it again last week, it's how good it is and how much I love it. I would say favourite film. Definitely.
Yeah, it's probably one of the best action adventures of the 80s, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Personally. It's got... What I love about The Predator is... It's got so many different looks about it, isn't it? It's invisible.
Yep.
You see it with its mask on, which looks space age. You see it without the mask.
Yep.
You see how he sees.
Mm-hmm.
He's got weapons. He's got technology, lasers.
He's like 8 foot tall.
Dreadlocks. He's cool.
Dreadlocks.
He looks cool.
Tell the dreadlocks. I thought you were talking about RoboCop. You know, you saw him before he died. You saw him with his mask. You saw him without the mask on.
Okay, you think you're talking RoboCop.
The weapons.
No, we're doing Predator.
Paul. Okay.
Predator. Definitely Predator. That's what I loved about Predator. Just, he was cool, wasn't he?
Predator
was cool. You see, he was scary, of course, you know, but, and it was a very gory film, but once you kind of get past that and, like, you realise Arnie beats him, he actually then goes on to everyone kind of thinks he's really cool and kind of people want him as their ally, for example, you know. You'd have... Alien versus Predator, for example, you'd have the Predator fighting the aliens on your side. You know, you'd want to be backed up by a Predator. But I remember watching this with my dad, far too young to be watching it, in 18. He's like, oh, stick that on, son.
What's your dad's name? Just shout out to your dad.
Jeff.
There's no point.
There's no point. He would not know how to work what a podcast is. He'd think it's a fishing tackle.
Yeah, brilliant.
You stick it on, because at the same time, he won't know how to turn it off either.
Yeah.
It's a good idea. Yeah.
Dad would not know, bless him. Sorry, I carry on.
God, I remember the first time I watched this as well, because it was Stephen Gordon's 15th birthday, I think. And we're going down to Blockbusters with his dad, because we couldn't rent it because it was an 18.
Yeah.
So I can't remember what the other film was. We picked up two movies. There was a few of us. And then
Rayman.
Yeah, was it Rayman? Yeah, we were watching Predator. We had the Domino's pizza.
Oh.
Yeah,
Predator. Friday nights or Saturday nights or whatever,
That sounds cool, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah.
It does sound cool.
And my dad used to love it. He used to quote all the things and then all the little bits about, like, this is Blaine and look at him. And loved it. Loved it. It's a great film. Again, watched it far too young. But it didn't really scar me for life.
Yeah, I think I watched it.
Inspired me.
Teens, probably. So I don't think I watched it.
So you've got the Predator, and you've got Arnie. Well, you've got a team of almost superheroes, aren't they? They're all built like...
Yeah, yeah.
Specimens. And then they're taking on the Predator. And it comes a real primal battle at the end. Oh, it's just perfection.
And you don't see it much either, which is cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
If you see something too much.
Yeah, I think it's about 40 minutes in, is it?
Yeah, and he only has like 8 minutes of screen time. Yeah. And I'll tell you something. When so my son Freddie, who is 10, when he was about 7, he plays Fortnite. And Predator come to Fortnite.
Mm-hmm.
And if you complete a task, you get the skin of Predator. And he was loving it. And I said, oh, this is from a film. He didn't know what it was. So we sat down, he's only 7, so if I get in trouble for this, to watch Predator. And we was watching it, and he got bored because you hardly see the Predator.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So in the end, we put on one of the latest ones. I think we watched The Predator, which is 2017, 2018 or something.
Terrible. It's just not as good.
But you see it a lot more, and it's not as cool, is it?
It
but
ruins
you see
it. That's the whole thing about it. When you saw the trailer and everybody was speaking about it, I guess in the 80s when you went to cinema, you didn't know what it was going to look like,
yeah.
You know, and that was the whole appeal. Now that you know,
yeah.
I mean, in Predator 2, they tried keeping it invisible for a while, and then the reveal later on. But you knew,
yeah,
there was expectation. The unknown, it was the unknown.
It's like Jaws.
Mm-hmm.
Jaws is cool, yes, isn't it? You just had the music and the water moving, and then someone's leg coming off.
Yep.
But then once you saw it for the first time, it's cool. But then the more and more you see something,
the more exposed to it, the less scared.
Yeah,
scaredish you get, I guess. But yeah, brilliant film.
I bought, just before Christmas, I got a TV VHS combo, whatever. And I bought Predator on VHS and watched it on there, and that was cool.
Yeah.
And
little 14-inch screen or whatever.
Yeah, and in my room, it was like a little glow in the corner. And it took me back to watching it when I was younger. But and it's so, obviously, VHS is so not clear at all, and you can hardly see anything. And when you do see Predator, even when it's on the screen, right in front of you, it's still like a bit unclear in that because it's VHS.
Mm-hmm.
That was cool. Anyway, never really scared me that much because it was daylight.
There's a few scary scenes in it, like when the bodies are hanging and you hear the vultures.
It's gory, isn't it? If you're squeamish,
because it was in the daylight. See, I just think if it's anything nighttime, it's scary, and aliens, and
I guess it's the invisibility thing, being hunted and not knowing you're being hunted.
Yeah,
that's, it's very cerebral. It's very kind of intense in that aspect. But yeah, not scary. Like, aliens used to scare me more. As a kind of concept. But Predator is impending danger of being sliced open at any time.
Yeah.
if you're in the Predator universe, I guess.
Yeah,
we had some big names in this film, didn't we?
Yeah.
Arnie, obviously. Dylan was Carl Weathers.
Yep.
Yeah.
Bill Duke was Mac.
Mm-hmm.
Jesse Ventura was Blaine,
who I knew from wrestling at the time.
Yes.
So it was he was a commentator, so it was very cool to see a commentator. And he said, he does movies too?
Yeah,
you know,
blew your mind when you're younger. And two governors. So the two governors were Arnie,
Jesse.
Yeah,
Jesse Ventura,
governor of California and Minnesota.
You got Sonny Landham as Billy, Richard Chavez as
Poncho.
Shane Black, who went on to direct The Predator.
Yep.
Yeah, because he actually wrote Lethal Weapon. He was, he was a screenplay writer, wasn't he? Director.
Yeah.
And I think he wrote and directed Iron Man
3. Iron Man 3, that's what it said at Christmas. Lethal Weapon said at Christmas. The Predator said at Christmas. He loves Christmas films.
He also wrote, so let's bring back the Die Hard link.
Die Hard link.
Sound the alarm, yes. Sound the alarm. It's The Last Boy Scout, starring Bruce Willis.
Okay.
And obviously, McTiernan.
John McTiernan directed both. So there's your biggest Die Hard link.
Yep.
And
are we going to sound it again?
We can send one more time.
Sound it again, Paul.
Commando was set on a fictional island called Valverde. Valverde is supposed to be where this fictitious jungle is.
Yeah, let me just scribble off my quiz. Chris question?
Oh, no, I got rid of the quiz.
It's always mentioned as like a South American jungle.
Yeah, but it's also mentioned in one of the... I think it's Die Hard 2. So...
Correct.
That is...
That's the link to Die
Hard.
They're
all in the same universe. Predator, Commander, which is weird because it's the same actor. Arnie's the same actor in two different things. So Predator, Commander and Die Hard all in the same cinematic universe.
And so Die Hard 2, I think it's the general, is from Valverde.
Valverde, right.
Yeah. But if you've seen Predators, which is 2010, 2011, I think.
Predators, Adrian Brody.
Yeah, let's not talk about that. the lady in it says, this story, you know, when they first encounter the Predator, they say, this brings me back to a story back in 1987. And they say, what's the country?
Guatemala.
Yes. They said it happened there. They didn't say Valverde, but it was supposed to be Valverde.
That's someone not doing their research, that is.
Yeah.
Should be fired.
They should have us doing it, shouldn't they?
Yeah, they should.
Can we do a Back to the Future link?
If you want to, go on, Paul.
Go on, then.
If there's anyone that's going to do it, it's you. Go on.
Well, believe it or not, there is a Predator link to Back to the Future.
Go on, then.
Go for
Let's
it.
Hear it.
So I thought, it's not very exciting, I'm afraid.
It's all right.
Alan Silvestri.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah,
who done the music to Predator, also done Back to the Future.
Yeah, that's the music from both.
Well done, Paul. Yes, well, you're right.
That'd be something. I couldn't think what the Back to the Future link.
No. Well, I've only seen this film a couple of times.
I thought you were going to say the Predator flies off in a DeLorean or something.
No, well, no. So I thought, well, how can I get involved in today's podcast? I thought, ah.
Okay, what do you think about it? Only seeing it a couple of times.
I saw
recently?
It once years ago.
Right, okay.
And I mean, recently. A long time ago. I couldn't remember anything about it. And obviously, I watched it this couple of times this week, ready for the podcast.
What do you think?
The first time I watched it, I messaged you earlier. Rob,
yeah.
Earlier in the week, Rob, didn't I? And I was like, not overly impressed.
Ah,
I don't get it. But.
Angry.
It's good, though, getting other opinions, isn't
but
it?
Yeah. I didn't get it. And to be honest with you, and I still hold, I prefer Commando. I know they're two different films.
Yeah.
But it's a similar sort of thing with Arnold Schwarzenegger, kind of what he's doing. Mm. And there's another chap, isn't there, in Commando, in
Bill Duke.
I recognised him, but I couldn't remember his name. So I've watched it a couple of times this week, and I've kind of got to enjoy it more as I've watched it. So it's pretty good. I prefer Commando, but
Arnie had just come off Commando and went into Predator. So
they should have been the same character. They should have been the same character.
It would have been cool if it was the same character, actually. That really would, because that would have worked, wouldn't it?
He's just saved Jenny from.
Let's just rewrite it.
Whatever it was.
If his name was John Matrix in Predator. Mm.
If it was,
you could have easily believed it.
It might have been even bigger.
Alan Schaefer, wasn't it? I think it was
really Dutch Schaefer.
Alan Dutch Schaefer.
Another quiz question after
Dutch
this.
Schaefer, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Alan, that's it. Yeah, Alan.
That wouldn't quite work.
Keep going, guys, because I'm really not looking forward to the quiz today. So the more you can get out now.
It didn't work. Yeah, Alan, just imagine
like
that.
Like a few things. I wonder what would have happened if they had all had English names. Like it was like Kevin, Michael,
Mark, Scott, Alan. Robert.
Some 80s names. We got some great 80s names, haven't we? Rob, Scott, Mark, and Paul.
Yeah.
Like those names.
That's
are definitely
the squad that going into the jungle. Yeah.
They're not in
Paul.
My son's class. Those names.
Paul, go ahead and scout.
Rob, put your phone down.
Rob, put your phone down. Set up camp.
Well, I just got
Scott. What tripwires along that eastern ridge?
Let me just finish this TikTok.
We move 50 meters spread. No sound. Oh, brilliant.
Robert, can you get your weapon out?
Yeah.
Where's Philip?
Yeah. Derek.
Oh dear.
Rodders.
Kevin Peter Hall, we didn't mention him.
Kevin Peter Hall.
And the same year, I think it was the same year, he played. Anyone know?
Bigfoot
yeah.
Henderson.
Big Harry. Yeah, Harry Henson's, yeah. Was it Harry was the Bigfoot? He was called Harry, wasn't he? Yeah. Yep.
Harry and Henson. And if you actually watch it, you can see very, very similar movement patterns to the way Predator moves. And
yeah, well, you did it the other day, didn't you? Is it work?
Yeah, sort of, and it's just
slow, sort of.
It's almost kind of creepy, you know, I mean, like murder, death person like Predator and this lovable giant Harry and the Hendersons moves the same kind of way. But he was a trained ballet dancer. He was 7'2"
yeah.
tall.
And of course it was going to be
Van Damme.
Van Damme.
And talk about the Van Damme thing.
Yep. But he was only 5'9", so it didn't quite work.
Yeah, fresh off the boat from Brussels, thinking that he was going to be this massive martial arts star going up against Arnie. And in the jungle with his red suit on, because red is the opposite to green, so that's how you can do the invisibility.
And they shot it twice.
He's like, I hate this. Why am I in this red suit? This looks ridiculous. I look like something out of...
But it did look crap as well.
It did look crap.
It looked like an insect. Have you seen it?
Yeah.
I've not seen the Van Damme one. No.
Oh, it's... Nah.
I'll put a picture on Instagram. But it looks like a giant insect walking around. Yeah. And because he's trying to do martial arts, it just looks comical in a way.
Mm.
It's like a kid's film, like an alien.
But like, so he was like, why am I, this, I look ridiculous. And he's like, well, Van, like Mr. Van Damme, you realise you're going to be invisible. That's why we're doing it in red. And he was even more angry then.
Yeah.
What? I'm not even going to be seen.
Yeah.
So he had a bit of an ego issue, bless him.
Probably did a roundhouse on the director or something.
I think he lasted a couple of days, but some of his stuff is in the...
He moaned a lot, didn't he, apparently?
Yeah, he moaned a lot.
So I've read.
Yeah.
So the film come about for a joke. Rocky IV finished.
Versus E.T.
And they thought,
who can Rocky fight now? He must need to fight an alien.
An alien. And it came and Jim and John Thomas were the writers, and it was their idea to do it. Nearly called Hunter, which works as well, doesn't it? But Predator's cooler.
Predator is cooler.
It is cooler. And it was nominated for an Oscar for Best Visual Effects.
I should have got that.
And it lost to... Anyone want to take a guess?
Clue.
You're never going to get it.
No.
87?
Yeah, well, it was, so it was the 88 Oscars, and 87 was the year of the film,
I'm trying to think what came out in 87.
I think only two were nominated.
He came second.
Yes,
in
a
space. Wow,
in a space.
Not seen that.
I had read that. No,
you've not seen it.
I've read that.
That's good.
In a space.
Right, yeah, you read it. Okay, that's good.
Space. Is that oh, the name of the guy. No,
not Dennis Quaid.
It is Dennis Quaid.
Yeah, he was the guy who. I don't know now. He wasn't a guy who went small, was he? That was someone else.
But Martin Short, I can't remember.
Could be.
Dennis Quaid did go small.
Was Dennis Quaid went small? Yes, and the other guy was.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, you're right. And what name did you say, Mark?
I'm not sure if it's right. I thought it was Martin Short, but I'm not sure if that's right, actually.
There's two Quaids, aren't there? There's the Quaid that was in Independence Day.
Same one.
And then there's two Quaids. And then there's a Quaid who's in Inner Space.
Ah, that's Will Smith, mate.
No. The Day After Tomorrow as well.
Monday.
Oh, fucking forget it. slack-jawed.
What is the... what's the alien called?
What do you mean, what's the alien called?
Yautja.
Yautja, yeah. I couldn't pronounce it, that's why I said, what's the alien called?
Yeah, that's, know that's how you pronounce it. The comics or something there. Yeah, the species is called the Yautja.
Yautja. Right, I think we have covered most things. Anyone else want to say anything before we...
Just, is it quiz time?
I noticed I was doing a little bit of research, but the tragedy regarding Kevin Peter Hall.
Yeah.
If you're aware, so he
passed away of...
Yeah, the film Predator 2, and then I think it was 91, he was in a car accident and had a blood transfusion and passed away from AIDS a few months after due to the blood transfusion.
Yeah, that sucks, doesn't it? Yeah.
So if it wasn't for the car accident then, which he didn't die of.
Yeah, he died of a transfusion and caught HIV through it.
And I saw a documentary, he seemed quite a cool guy, wasn't he?
Everyone who's been interviewed said he is the nicest person. The consummate professional, the nicest person
to
work with.
He didn't bitch about the costume.
Not at all, considering he was in it for hours at a time. Yeah. It seemed great.
And he obviously was actually in the film right at the end, wasn't he? He was in the chopper.
Yeah.
We did a quiz last year or something like that and said, what's the name of the actor? And I was like, and I was like, you never see him. And say, yes, you do! And I shouted out in front of everybody.
Yeah.
You do see him! No, you don't. You do! He's the
get this guy out of here.
Yeah, he is. Settle down. Yeah. He was a chopper pilot.
Yeah, he sort of pulls his glasses down a little bit, didn't he? And sort of says,
What the?
Yeah. Which is quite cool. I think, so the director, you know, as for him putting up with the costume and doing all that,
that's
he can have a small part, which is quite cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, shall we go through Predator?
Ooh, let's do it.
Paul.
Robert.
How's it start? It's like school, isn't it? No, you're joking.
Yes, sir.
20th Century Fox.
Mm-hmm.
And then the spaceship, which I always forgot about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Forgot about that little spaceship.
It always comes from it comes out of like the black.
Yeah.
And I thought it was a star that started moving, but it's not. The star or the spaceship does appear and then comes forward. So I always look for the star to see if it's there or not.
When's this?
Right at the beginning. It literally says Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah,
Predator. And you see the ship and then the pod dropping down to Earth.
I must have missed that bit. I would not talk for a minute. You're talking about a different film. I'm doing E.T.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's in it. Did you see him in it when you watched it?
You can hardly not see him.
Big guy.
That's one of my favourite things about the film is there's like, no messing about. It's like
straight
in. End credits are over. The aliens landed. Schwarzenegger and the team landed in the chopper.
Yeah.
It's like Mum and Dad Predator's dropped off little Predator to go and play.
Well, it is like that. Apparently, like if you read into the lore and stuff, they get dropped off for like rites of passage, you know, like in the Serengeti, the Masai Mara, they would have to go and kill a lion to become like a man in the tribe. This is what they kind of do to the juvenile predators, as you were. So he was like kind of left onto Earth to kind of go, right, go on, see how you get on. And sometimes they make it back and sometimes they don't. And they've been doing it for years, as Anna says later on in the which is great because that establishes a backstory and a history and this has been going on for ages. Only on hot summers.
So I reckon Predator's like going like, where should we, you know... Go somewhere it's hot.
They like the
hot. They like conflict, don't they?
Yeah. They like hot.
Come in Predator 2.
And they like conflict, much more, but they like conflict, that's why.
Yeah.
to LA in the 90s.
Yeah.
And we get the helicopter landing, and they all the guys jump out, don't they?
So you get introduced to all of the team getting out. They've all got their own looks, and I was watching the video yesterday saying it's like they were all just doing their daily stuff, and they're like giving a call. Quick!
Yeah, yes.
You know, you need to get suits,
But then Arnie's in the back, lights up a cigar.
Did you know a little fact about this?
Yes, I just found this out last night.
Go on, go for it. Fact, is it?
No, it's not a Carl Weathers fact. I thought, and I never assumed any other, that he actually lit that cigar.
Ah, yes.
But of course, my stupid little brain, health and safety. So it's cartoon.
Yes, I see.
And when you look, it's very red when he first lights it, but then it cuts closer up, and then it is a flame, and then obviously he's not in a helicopter for that. It's done so it looks like he's in it.
Mm.
So you look at the two colours, the red flame, and it's sort of like more of a proper flame in the second shot.
But of course he's not going to be able to light a naked flame inside a chopper.
Yeah.
But he only got Carl Weathers addicted to them.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cigars. I love that fact.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that fact. He's like clean living, Mr. Healthy Apollo Creed. Here, have a cigar.
And they're all like competing about who had the biggest arms, didn't they? And things
Ventura
like that.
And him, yeah.
They're like getting up earlier and earlier each day to work out.
Yeah, and it got to like 3 a.m. or something stupid like that. But Carl Weathers liked to make people believe his physique was God's gift and that he didn't have to work out to maintain it, so it'd always work out when other people weren't around.
I read something as well about the competition. They had Sue had the biggest biceps.
Yeah,
and Arnie he said to his was
someone
smaller.
In wardrobe or something like that.
Yeah,
tell Jesse Ventura that he had bigger biceps than Arnold. Yeah,
and they bet on something, and when they went to measure him, he was like, "Oh my God, yours are much bigger."
Yeah.
And they meet. They got off the chopper. And they go meet the general.
Yep.
Who tells them? Still confuses me. What's going on?
Okay. So they're brought in to rescue what they believe is a cabinet minister who's been shot down, or the chopper's gone missing, across in the jungle.
Mm.
And Dutch spots that it's on the wrong side of the border. They shouldn't be flying over there.
Yeah.
Well, apparently they got straight off course. Okay, so why do you need us? You know, why don't you use your army to go in and get there? Because some damn fool accused you of being the best.
Dylan!
You son of a bitch.
Yeah. He looks around, doesn't he, Dutch? He's like,
said that to me.
Oh, it's you, Dylan.
Oh, it's you, yeah.
And then the handshake of all handshakes.
Yeah. I mean, one of the greatest scenes ever. Yeah.
When they did it, all my pictures in my room fell off the wall. And you got the t-shirt on, Scott, haven't you?
I do, an exact scene.
We'll put that on Instagram.
Yeah,
I want that t-shirt, it's quite cool.
I think when we do the picture, you and I should reenact the scene.
Do it.
We perhaps get AI to
son of a bitch.
Beef up our muscles.
Yeah.
Tell you what.
So it's not like we've just come back from bingo.
If I hadn't had a little girl and we had a little boy instead, I was going to push for his name to be Dylan. So I could shout, Dylan, you son of a bitch, get back here.
But your daughter's name is
Anna. Stasia.
Yeah. And is Anna in the film?
Anna is in the film. Do you know what? That's Survivor. The first time I've even spotted that. Yeah.
Did your wife know that?
Nope.
I'm going to change her name now, aren't
she? I say she'll find out now, but she ain't going to listen.
Yeah, they never do. They never do. We say this every week. CIA got you pushing too many pencils.
CIA got you pushing too many pencils?
Yeah.
Make it easier on yourself, Dutch.
What's this tie business?
What is this fucking tie business? Oh.
And then we go to the chopper scene.
Yep.
Which
so
is cool,
they load up,
it?
You find out that, you know, they're God a rescue team, not assassins. My team works alone, even though we're good friends. I'm pissed off that you're coming with me.
Yeah, he wasn't happy, was he, that?
Straight to the chopper, reminiscence of Vietnam, and you find out that Dylan and Dutch were in Vietnam together.
Yeah.
He tries to impress us. Like, we both got this lighter from Vietnam, and the rest of the team are like, fuck off.
Yeah.
Spits on his shoes and stuff.
Yeah. Blames off him tobacco.
You get introduced to all the other members of the team. Who's the Joker?
Max having a shave.
They all got like interesting character traits.
Must be running late, mustn't he?
Yeah.
You're going out to war. I mean, that's one thing I remember throughout watching this film. Man, how many times this bloke shaved?
I think it's to try and relax him, isn't it?
Yeah, I reckon
it's
a tick.
It's his thing.
Yeah.
It's his tick. Yeah. It's his coping mechanism. It's unique.
Like, yeah.
Everyone, so you got the same problem, Rob.
Everyone thinks about it, don't they? Everyone's, you know, like, they'll just go, you, Predator, shaving. That's probably what he gets all the time.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Interesting, so, do you know he directed Sister Act?
Oh, did he?
Bill Duke.
Oh, right.
He directed Sister Act. I only found that out the other day.
Didn't know that.
No, neither did I. I thought that was awesome.
Yep, and then they get to the point and they abseil out of the chopper.
Yeah, what I like about this is Little Richard's playing in the background. You're like, oh, yeah, they're going into battle. They're enjoying it. But when, like, Arnie kind of goes, right, it's time, you realise the music isn't just in the background of the film, like a soundtrack. They're actually listening to it and he clicks off.
Yeah.
And it's like a switch from fun to action mode instantly. Yeah.
That's been really loud, that ghetto blast.
Yes.
In a helicopter.
Yeah. I love that. It kind of like it just goes straight to action and they all abseil out and then boom, they're in the jungle.
Billy drinks from a vine, sort of Ray Mears style, then he kind of cuts him.
Yes, yeah.
With his big machete.
But so he hears some birds. I've noticed this. He hears some birds, which I guess were vultures, I suppose.
Yeah, they're feeding on
something. What could they be feeding on?
Do you know what you also hear for the first time?
Yes. Did you hear last night for the first time? I've watched this millions of times, and you hear the. Can I do the impression?
Go on, do your impression. Yeah, that's really good. Actually,
good.
Well,
you hear that then?
I can't do it. Yeah, you hear it then, but you don't know what it is then.
Yeah,
at that time. So you don't. That's why you don't pay attention to it really.
Yep.
But they discovered skinned corpses.
Yeah.
Of the guys that they are hunt or that they're trying to rescue.
Yeah.
And no, they're not trying to rescue.
No, they're not. Actually. See, it's confusing, isn't it?
Yeah, they're not trying. They're going after the helicopter.
Yeah. So these must be in the previous rescue attempt.
Yes.
This is it.
Yeah.
And then it all starts, well, it starts to kind of get a bit suspicious.
And what's the name of one of the guys?
Jim Hopper.
From Stranger Things?
Who is the guy from Stranger Things, which some people have argued that is.
Do you reckon it is in? Do you reckon, so he left Hawkins in about 86.
Yeah.
And then got a job as a commando guy in 87.
Green Berets at a Fort
I can't Barrett. See that Jim Hopper
no.
with his build.
But it's clearly what they got it from. Yeah. And Hawkins, the name of the town.
Of course.
Hawkins, the name of Shane Black's character as well.
Yep, they come down. And the camera keeps like panning around the jungle, doesn't it? And I keep trying to look to see if I can see him.
Yeah, I don't think there is.
No, he's not, is he? He's not there. And I think you first see the infrared scene comes up then, which is obviously...
Which again, you're thinking, what the hell is this?
It's still quite cool now, isn't it? It's
very dated by today's standards of infrared technology, but it's very cool. Like the blue and the red.
But the film was like Mark, you said a while back, didn't you, about...
You can't date the film, is that...?
Yeah, apart from that technology bit.
Yeah, maybe... And you don't even know when the film really is set.
Yeah.
No.
There's no reference, apart from maybe the clothes you've seen the guys getting off the chopper. Maybe the suits look a bit dated, but apart from that...
Yeah, because military clothing.
There's no buildings, there's no cars, there's no fashion, really. There's nothing to date.
That's a very good point.
So if you took away the Predator's technology bit, when his infrared bit...
You could just say that's Alien, couldn't you?
Yeah,
so you don't have to say it's... Judge it by our standards.
A bit I thought was funny was when Dylan slips.
Yeah.
And Max, like, you have better impressions
of me. This motherfucker. Yeah. Yeah, you are back in the world. You can have a session one more time. I'll bleed you. Required. Leave you here.
Reminds me of Mr. T.
Yes.
I'm just waiting for it to go, like, I'll bleed you real good. Ain't got no plane. Oh, I love Mr. T.
He would have been in this team.
He wouldn't have flown there, though, would he? Wouldn't have gone in the helicopter.
He wouldn't have flown there. No.
They'd have given him some milk.
Yeah.
Give him some milk, and then woke up in the jungle. How many times did he fall for that? Every episode, wasn't it? But we got to go to Mexico, BA. I ain't going down there. I ain't going there. Ain't got no plane, fool. Have some milk. Okay, you have some milk. Wakes up, Mexico. That's good. A-Team. We were doing A-Team episode.
Well, yeah, branching out from cinema to TV, but yeah for sure.
Then they stumble across the enemy.
The down chopper. Is the down chopper? Is that before or after they discover the corpses?
Before. That's straight away, actually. Right. We missed that, didn't we? Yeah. And then we get the enemy camp with hostages.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The two pilots, actually.
They took
two of the pilots. Ah. One's already dead, and the other gets shot in front of Dutch's eyes.
That's brutal.
Yeah,
it was a brutal one. Yeah,
it looked real, didn't it? It looked really good. No, not with good, but it looked, yeah, it looked really realistic.
Yeah,
so they had a plan. They could have just thrown grenades into the camp and killed everyone, but
yeah, this is one of the things that I get not so sure about this bit. Obviously, when he lifts the back, yeah. There's a guy stood just in front of the truck and he's sort of like there.
Yeah.
Cuts the sort of fan about, doesn't he? And
I think then
lifts it. Yeah. He's even here, they've got logs falling.
I think they would have thought.
Yeah, they would not heard.
You look at that guy as well, he keeps looking to the right, like, waiting for it to move.
He does, yeah, I've seen that.
But it's like, shall we throw some grenades in there? And Dutch's like, I tell you, I've got a better idea.
That's a massive diversion.
I'm going to go and lift the truck up, put a grenade in it and let it roll down.
But
carry on, Paul.
Isn't that not how they do the 80s? Because that does feel very A-team type.
Yeah.
How they done it.
And the bodies, you know, they got like a camera underneath and the body flies over.
Yeah.
That's a bit like the A-team, isn't it?
It's again very much Commando. It's just like a couple of shots and then five people die and loads of mass action. It's great. But someone made a comparison to that scene where he obviously throws a truck into the middle of things to confuse them while attacking. Predator does the same thing with a boar. Remember?
Right.
Later on in the film?
Yeah.
He
sends a boar in to distract them all.
Yeah.
To nick.
Oh, so he sent that in, did he?
The Predator did, yeah.
I didn't realise that. Sorry, I only sent the boar. Right.
To nick thingy's Blaine's body. Spoiler. So great action scene, them kicking ass.
Stick around.
Knock, knock.
Ad-libbed, apparently, those two lines.
Yes.
Which is cool.
Stick around. It's such an Arnie thing, isn't it?
Mm.
It's good. Then we also get the son of a bitch stuck in like an Alabama tick.
You're hit. You're bleeding, man. Oh, great line. I ain't got time to bleed.
Yeah.
I ain't got time for that shit. Let's get on with it.
Yeah. That's like my dad when he's down in the garden. Shout out to my dad. Hi, Dad. Say he's down in the old days, he used to be like down in the pigeon loft fixing something and making a compartment. I'll go down there and he'd cut his head or something, knocked his head on something. I'm like, Dad, your head, you're bleeding there. Are we going to get a plaster? I ain't got time for that.
Gotta knock this thing up in, you know, before daylight's out.
Yes, it, yeah. Yeah, that's a good one. Dutch realises it's a setup, doesn't he?
Yes. So Mac found the other guy. He's there too.
Yeah.
But for the look of it, our cabinet minister is CIA. Other guys they waxed, Russian military advisors. So what it is, Dylan wanted them to be sent in to stop a Russian-backed invasion of a neighbouring country. So that's why Dylan got them in. He cooked up the cover story of the cabinet minister rescue mission, blah, 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 blah. In the meantime, they didn't count on the fact that there was a massive alien stalking the trees, looking for who's the best soldiers in the world to take on as trophies.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like two or three stories mixed in one there, which kind of makes for a recipe for a great movie.
Definitely.
But again, growing up, never understood what the hell was going on.
No. When you're younger, though...
Where's the Predator? Where's the Predator?
You don't really follow plots, do you, when you're a kid?
Nah.
You're just watching the action.
We're saying that, though. It's like other films that we've watched, we've kind of like, oh, now I get it. But this one, still, you're kind of like, so they're going to do that. It's very loosely explained and narrated.
To be honest, I still don't know what's going on. The scorpion scene's funny because when Dylan's walking around, you don't see this scorpion on his back, do you?
Mm.
And then he says, like, over here. And then when he does put the knife in it, you see it's like you see a little bit of like chewing gum or bubble gum. It's like
they can't actually chew a thing. What's it? Defra, whoever look after animals.
Scorpion King.
Yeah. They would go crazy if a scorpion was skewered on screen. Yeah.
And then when he stands on it, I noticed this mistake without looking up. He's sort of facing one way. When he lifts his boot up, the scorpion's facing the other way.
It's a magic trick, isn't it?
Yeah. I noticed that one. And then the Predator comes into the camp and it means he's close.
He's checking out the aftermath. Hawkins gets Billy to laugh, which Predator loves and records.
Yep, with his second joke.
Yeah,
that he likes to say.
Yeah, let's not say that.
Yeah, let's not say it.
We'll offend somebody. But gets him to laugh finally.
Yeah,
and
this that one was that the one when the echo part.
It was the echo, yeah.
Good joke. I thought it was quite funny. But we won't say it. We don't want to lose any listeners, do we? We don't want to take it down to four or five listeners. Billy spots something in the trees again. I'm still looking. I'm like, still trying to find what he's looking
at. I'm not sure if it's there or not. No. I don't know. I couldn't find anything on, like, in the special edition DVD kind of segments. There wasn't anything about it there.
Yeah. Oh, they capture Anna, don't they?
Anna.
Yeah. And she escapes, doesn't she?
So after dragging her along for ages, yeah, and like the whole scene with Billy kind of going, there's something in those trees, can you see it? And he's like, no. Oh, well, it's probably nothing then.
Yeah. Well,
Jesus Christ, Billy, what the hell are you doing?
Yeah.
So he's clearly on this, you know, the Navajo tracking instinct.
Yeah, he's sensing something, isn't he? Yeah.
Which is great because that links back to, I know they didn't know that Prey was coming out, but the Prey film where it was all like the Indians and stuff taken on.
Yeah.
That kind of has that association there, which is nice to look back to. But
yeah, well, this film was supposed to be a Native American as the lead role.
I've heard that.
I don't know if it's supposed to be Billy, but and it was supposed to be lots of aliens as well, not just one.
Right.
But then they sort of flipped it and they had
like a safari game park.
But I think one's better than lots.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, and then the something comes out of the jungle and takes Hawkins.
Yeah, as Anna's is running away, Hawkins is the first to catch her, and the Predator sees his opportunity to.
Yeah, it's seconds, isn't it?
Like, yeah.
Did you find Hawkins? I can't tell.
Yeah. I can't. That's such a great principle. It's like, I can't tell if it's him or not.
Yeah.
What the hell does that mean?
Yeah. If his glasses would have been like on top of the intestine.
What in God's name? Where is his body?
And that's the start of it all going to shit now, really.
Yes. It is. Yeah, the first of them's dead.
Yeah, you're right. I think Blaine go next, is he? Is he gone? His next scene, I think.
Yes.
Yes. So they try and find Hawkins' body. And Dutch is the closest, like there's a drip of blood like right next to where he's looking, and he would have spotted it but he doesn't, and then it pans up and you see that Hawkins' body's hanging up in the trees.
Yeah, sick, isn't it?
Yeah,
because when Blaine dies, it's like a shot, it sort of like blinds him or something, or does it miss him
and stun
like,
him or
a flash of something, blood on his neck.
Something happens
sort of must hit his
and he's in shock. I reckon I sort of like, what's that, and then all of a sudden the big one comes
through is the back of his chest. Well, the back, sorry, explodes out of his chest. Blood everywhere.
Yep, and then Max's him. Max is the invisible yellow eyes. Like
that. It disappeared.
And then we get the famous shooting scene.
Yeah. Great scene.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is, you know, they're firing blindly into the desert, jungle, all directions. Billy noticed that's what the original Hopper's team were doing. Strange, Major. They were firing in all directions. So it's that same kind of thing. It's like they're just going crazy, and it's nuts, isn't it? It was a great scene to see them, just five or six people side by side, opening up their guns.
This massive. It's like, well, we're going to go in the jungle, lads. Travel light.
Blaine brings his minigun.
What you got in your bag, Blaine?
I've got a mounted minigun on my back.
Thought I'd bring this. It's impossible to hold it, apparently. It was like they had to make it lighter to hold it. They had to slow it down.
But it's cool as hell, right?
Yeah. Imagine that. Who's carrying the gun? Oh, I'll carry it.
Yeah.
Travel light, guys.
That makes his character, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And Mac is starting to lose it as well, I thought. Yes.
He is. After Blaine dies, he really starts to descend into madness.
Yeah.
Grief takes him.
Shot the jungle, they think they didn't hit anything, but they obviously.
Yes, you see the blood.
Didn't they? Yeah.
Do you know what that's made out of?
Yes.
Glow sticks.
Is it broken glow sticks, which I love the idea of.
Yeah.
There goes another quiz question.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Actually, yeah, it is.
Oh, damn it. You're not going to have a quiz left.
I always struggle. This is a tough one to get questions for because it's like just jungle. There's not many. And they go to someone else's house, and then someone else's house, and they go, this is all just. But I've got one, don't worry. Don't worry, listeners. So, I know.
I've been quite happy we're going to have no quiz.
If you win this quiz, Paul, I'll give you £500.
Now, what quiz was it in the first season we done when I robbed Scott right at the end?
It was close, wasn't it? Yeah, because I was trying to get the scores. I was going through them last night.
I randomly gave an answer.
It was right, yeah, wasn't it?
And it was right, which I won the quiz.
Yeah, I can't think what it was.
Scott was crying like a baby.
Yeah.
Don't remember that.
But can you imagine if I win today's quiz, like his best film?
You won't see me again.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just sat over here quiet, taking it all in. You know.
I should have gave you my quiz questions and you should have, like, and then won it. Yeah.
Got every single one
10-0
right.
To Paul.
I think Scott would have smelt a rat.
Yeah, I reckon so. Yeah, so what was the green blood, did we say?
Broken ghost.
Glow stick.
Oh, yeah, snapped. Glow stick snapped in half.
Yeah.
Yeah, green one.
Yeah. It's quite clever, isn't it?
Mm.
He was a good soldier. He was my friend.
Yeah.
Nice bit.
Yeah.
Because they were best mates, I reckon. They were buddies, weren't they? Because when he's lying down, he like has a sip of his whiskey, doesn't it? And then puts it on his body, and which is like a cool thing. But this is when we first see the Predator, because he takes his invisibility, he takes Harry Potter's invisibility cloak off and he fixes his wound, doesn't he?
Yeah, you first see him. And you get established that it's a healing, you know, they've got technology and it can heal itself. And they hear that massive scream, and they're all just starting to really panic now.
Yeah, because Poncho goes, he says to Billy, you know something.
I'm scared, Poncho.
Yeah.
Bullshit, you ain't afraid of no man. Which is a great setup.
Yeah. Something out there waiting for us.
Ain't no man.
Yeah. Go, kill us all or something.
You're all going to die.
You're all going to die, that's it, Mac takes watch. This is a good scene when it's like some sort of music plays.
Yeah,
and he looks in the moon.
Mm. Yeah.
And it's great, and he's sweating, he's holding his gun, he's shaking up.
He looks like he's almost crying as well.
It's good acting there.
Grief. Yeah, Bill Duke's great.
He is good, isn't he?
Yeah.
The bit of the boar is good as well. He's like, he's actually fighting a boar, and he's looking up at him, and it's bright.
It's
isn't
that the kind of one he's like, fuck you, Poncho.
Yeah.
It's like, as you would if someone was was ribbing you. You're like, fuck off, right? God's sake.
Yeah, he was.
Killed you, fuck.
I like potty mouth.
Still, well, I'm going to get the bleeping on this.
There's a lot of swearing in Predator, what can I say?
Yeah, there is a lot of swearing. Mac is losing it. They set up flares, catch the boar. And then all of a sudden, Blaine's body's gone, isn't it?
Yep.
But not the.
He wants the trophy.
Yeah.
It was the trophy of the body.
But he didn't take the guns, which is weird, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
They can't quite work out. So they still don't realise this is an alien,
and now, they just think it's, people.
Yeah, Dutch realises the Predator's using the trees.
He's using the trees. You've seen the, have a look at, if you've not seen it before, The Predator the Musical. Have you seen it?
No. Is that a musical?
It's great. It's a satire. It's somebody
making fun.
Like Arnie's accent, and he's just like, it's using the trees, stalking and hunting. Oh, this is brilliant. Have a look on YouTube.
It sounds like someone would be in The Simpsons.
It's the same kind of like, same ilk. It's really good.
Predator the
Check
musical.
It out, it's hilarious. Stop shaving, you don't have a beard.
Oh, that does sound funny.
Because this is when you start realising that they're suspecting this is not human. Because I think, is it Dylan says something like, what are you doing with this old Boy Scout bullshit?
Yeah.
Like, you can see its tripwires, maybe it can't see this. So they're starting to use different tactics.
Yeah.
Aren't
they? Yeah.
Right.
Their resourcefulness. Great scene as well, when they're all like,
it's a
manly man.
A montage of setting traps.
Yeah.
bit Home Alone on.
Isn't it?
It's Home Alone in the jungle.
We need to set some traps. Let's get naked and set some traps. Like, everyone take their tops off.
We're getting a spray A-teamy like.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But they're not shooting cabbages out of
cabbages.
18 episodes. They get locked in a garage, don't they?
I only got a welder in here.
There's a welder with JCB.
That's some cabbages. I remember that, Still cool though, wasn't it? You still loved it.
I loved it.
Brilliant. If they'd only took some cabbages,
didn't question it,
Predator would have been dead in no time. Anna says there's something else. When the big man was killed, you must have wounded it. It was on the trees.
She does a little monologue about only in the hottest years this happens.
Yeah.
And we find our men butchered, sometimes worse. And she says something like, El Diablo, something in Spanish or whatever.
Yeah.
Basically, the demon who makes trophies of men.
Yeah, that's a good line, isn't it?
Whoa. You have to get the line out. If it bleeds,
kill
it. Yes.
Which is right. If all of a sudden they realise it's wounded. Yeah, it's not like Superman who's going
to... Yeah, and they start, you're right, they're starting to use it, aren't they, rather than... Dylan still thinks it's two or three men out there.
Yes.
Yeah. They set a traps, didn't they? And they're sort of waiting for it. This is quite creepy and it's not coming, so...
This is it. This is what... Like, Predator's not scary. It's the...
Suspense.
Suspense. Yeah. And sitting there and waiting.
Yeah, and he sort of goes... He walks out, doesn't he? And then all of a sudden, trap goes behind him. Behind him. And it sounds like a monkey going up.
Yeah. It's great, yeah, screaming because he wasn't expecting that at all.
I can't imagine a Predator making that noise, so.
No, it definitely is.
Yeah. Well, it was English, wasn't it?
The only time you see it panics, they got a one up on it.
Yeah. Yeah, she said about it happens in the hottest years. She said, she also said, found our men without their skins and sometimes much worse. Mm. I thought, what, they were wearing a Tottenham Hotspur shirt?
Oxford.
Go on, you gooners. Demon Matrix for men. Yeah, I said, we said that. What have we got next? Oh, the log comes down, doesn't it?
Hits
Poncho.
Sorry,
that would smash you up, wouldn't
it? He's broken a few ribs. I reckon internal bleeding. Yeah, he's dead.
He's not going to survive that.
No. I can make it.
Yeah,
not so sure.
They don't leave him though. They do get him up, don't they? And again, Mac is losing it even more. He starts. This is when he chases the Predator, isn't it?
He goes after him.
Starts quoting Long Tall Sally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to have some fun. Long Tall Sally.
And Dylan follows him then.
Yes, he wants to go look after Matt, then he'll chase. Yeah.
Sort of, the others are going to go to the chopper, aren't they?
Yeah.
Dylan says, no, I'm going to follow
Matt. That's it.
Dutch gives him his other gun, doesn't he? So he's got two guns now.
Dylan's just like in his sort of waistcoat thing. Nothing else, isn't he? He grabs the gun, isn't he? Oh, he's massive, isn't he?
Twin MP5s. Yeah, he's kicking ass.
He's big, isn't he? He's a big old boy, isn't he?
Yeah, Apollo Creed versus the Predator.
He catches up with old Mac.
Yeah.
And Mac spotted Predator, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Out there past the trees. I see you. He wants him, doesn't he? He wants him just for revenge. He don't care.
I love it.
He wants revenge for his friend, doesn't he?
Yeah.
They're not scared anymore. They're just pissed off.
Yeah, yeah. You killed my best mate.
Yeah.
But Mac's death's a bit...
It is such a anticlimax.
Yeah.
He's laying down as well. He's not like putting up a... You thought Predator would want to fight, wouldn't you?
Yeah, yeah.
And you just get the red dots on his arm.
Introduced to the red dots now, aren't you? Yeah,
that's it, the red dots, first time we see him. And then it goes on his head and then blasts his head off, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But then a few minutes later, you see him laying there with his face intact, don't you?
So I think it's not supposed to blast his head off. It looks like it blasts his head off, but it just goes through his head. Because later on, you see him, Predator, with the skull.
Yeah.
And there's a great big hole in...
Yeah.
One of the skulls, that's
the skulls, isn't he? Yeah, and he's like cleaning them, isn't he? Predator.
There's trophies.
Yeah, he's like, he's got OCD, he's like lining them up. These are brilliant. I've got some brilliant skulls here. Yeah. Got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Clubman of the Year, Man of the Match.
He is loving it, old Predator. He went to get home and show his family how many he's got.
Well, that's the idea. You get back, show the tribe, and then you're initiated into the Yautja tribe.
Yeah. And
he didn't survive.
A more gruesome death is Dylan's.
Dylan's, through the chest, picked up.
Yeah.
You don't see it.
And his arm. His arm
blown off, of course.
Yeah, but the gun's still firing. So we're coming towards the end, aren't we? What we get next? Oh, they go over the log, don't they? Yes. And then Billy.
Billy has his last stand. Billy's last stand.
Yeah, one of the disappointing scenes of the film, I think.
Yeah,
is you don't get to see Billy's fight or death. But he's like, he sort of basically he wants to fight him, but he's also letting the others get away, isn't he? He's like, you know, I'll hold him up for you.
Yeah.
Lasts about 3 seconds and he's dead. This is the famous line coming up, isn't it?
Yeah, Arnie's favourite line ever, apparently.
Yeah, because he realises that if you don't have a gun.
Yeah,
it doesn't kill because you're unarmed.
So if he had dropped his gun and just walked off,
no, because he knew that he was a warrior, but she wasn't.
Right.
But if she took that step and picked up and started firing, he would then go, right, you're dead.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah, this is when Poncho actually gets killed now, isn't it?
Yeah. Shot blast straight through the head.
Yeah.
Yep. But then Arnie says,
"I'll be back."
You're close.
Close, yeah.
And Arnie says,
I'm coming back.
No, no, no. Give me your clothes, your boots, and no, no.
Hasta la vista,
no,
baby.
No, no,
oh,
no.
Where are we?
Scott, you can do it, Scott. You can do a good Arnie impression. Go on.
Go! Get to the chopper!
Which is cool, isn't it? What a cool line.
Yeah.
I prefer I'll be back.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. His favourite line, you say,
he doesn't get it in this film, does he? I'll be back. Because a lot of Arnie films he does, but he doesn't. But then this is his own thing, isn't it? This is his own.
Yeah, because Terminator was what, 84? So it was before.
He says it in Commando.
Yeah. And then everything else.
Pretty much everything else.
He couldn't really say get to the chopper in Kindergarten Cop or or Junior.
They say it, you told me the other day, in what is it, The Predator, they
the
say.
The Predator, get to the choppers.
Get to choppers, as in the bikes.
The motorbikes, and it just feels shoehorned in.
I thought it was quite cool.
No.
No, I liked that.
No, flamethrower it all.
No, okay. Yeah, because then Dutch gets shot. A laser comes and hits him, doesn't it?
Yeah, shot in the shoulder, didn't he? Yeah.
Yeah.
Apparently it hits his gun. And deflects.
I just thought it is,
but
a little bit of blood, isn't there? But it doesn't seem.
He gets a scratch on his arm. Yeah.
His pecs are so big, it just rebounds off his pecs. Nobody can kill me. My pecs are too big. And then he runs and slips, and he goes off the cliff.
Yeah,
and you see this scene. He's definitely going to hit the ground there. There's rocks.
Yeah,
there's rocks and everything there. He's dead. End
of film. Suspend your disbelief for a second.
He's dead, and all of a sudden lands in the water, which is like 50 foot.
Yeah.
There's a little pond. You just didn't see it.
I think this is the thing that's so great about it, because obviously he goes down a couple of waterfalls, gets to the mud, and just collapses, doesn't he?
Yeah. Stuntman smashed his knee up doing that.
Really?
Jump, apparently, yeah.
He collapses and he's like, oh, he's safe, and then lands in the water right behind you, and you think, Jesus Christ, he's still after him. That's what was so kind of anxiety kind of inducing about it. It's just like he's constantly coming,
relentlessness,
and it's always over his shoulder two or three times. Like I think it happens the water, it happens later on when he's preparing to battle him, and then Predator just appears behind him and he doesn't realise, and then he does it when Predator sets a trap for him and Predator's bleeding and he's running after him. Every time it's over his shoulder,
he goes for his knife and realises he hasn't got it,
but then later on he does
later on he's using his knife.
Then he only does have it.
I thought this watching
Give a Knife, I didn't pick up on it.
You see the Predator. Well, you've already seen the Predator for a snapshot behind a tree.
Yeah,
but this is where it's the full reveal.
Yeah,
the invisibility is malfunctioning.
And that blue sort of light
sparking,
which happens at the end when he sets the bomb off. That was big in the '80s, wasn't it? That blue sort of, you remember when Terminator appears? That was blue lightning. It's like that. The effect
bit of
static the 80s,
electricity.
Yeah. He covers in mud and he realizes he can't see him, which MythBusters covered, and they said this would only work for about 5 minutes because then it would heat up.
Yeah.
Constantly reapplying.
Pretty much all the time. And then he starts, a montage of setting a trap, doesn't it? And which is cool. Arnie's again sort of making a bow and arrow out of a tree.
Yeah.
Very clever.
When I did that when I was younger, it'd be like a stick and then I'd do it and it'll go like 1 foot.
although even when Dutch fires the arrow, the sort of flame-filled arrow, it doesn't actually go that fast.
No, really? Yeah, you're right. So
it looks like it's just kind of falling down.
Yeah.
What does he make? A spear? He's got two grenade ammunition kind of slugs, as it were.
Yeah, gunpowder out of, doesn't he?
Yes, it. He's got two of them. He has his knife, which he makes a spear out of. He makes a bow and arrow and a great big trap.
This cool
spikes
isn't it?
Coming down, which was supposed to, like, the rope would come up and put him into the spikes.
And then he calls him, doesn't he? Basically, it's a cool scene where he lights the primal scream, sort of.
A primal scream, a challenge.
I'm ready.
Yeah.
Kick off.
All the technology's gone. And again, this takes it back. It could be a place in any time, really. You know?
That cool scene where he's hugging the tree and he's waiting for him. And all of a sudden, you see invisibility.
Over the shoulder thing.
He's right behind him. Yeah. So what's? Hold on a minute. He wasn't supposed to be there.
That's the anxiety thing. He's just like, right, what's going to happen? Holy shit, it's behind him. Arnie's behind you.
Yeah. And he swings to another tree like Tarzan.
Yeah.
And shoots his bow. Yeah. Yeah, that was eerie. God, wasn't expecting that. I must admit, I didn't think it was going to come right behind him.
You don't expect it in the water either. So that's why it's very clever.
And he's basically getting his ass kicked as well. And the Predator is like.
Predator's losing. Predator's panicking as well. I saw again another video last night that comparison of, you know, when Predator's attacking them and they're firing in the blindly. Arnie is attacking him, you know. Arnie's now invisible to him, so the hunter's becoming the hunted, and he's firing madly into just everywhere,
trying to work out where the
just
arrow,
like,
whatever.
Yeah, so it's like a complete role reversal, which is very clever.
He gets him in a trap. Oh, does he remove his mask? He removes his mask just before the final
yeah,
scene,
so blah blah blah. Arnie gets a few hits in, he's bleeding. You have the cool scene where he's underneath the log and Predator walks over it.
Wouldn't that be cool when he takes his mask off and it'd been a T-800?
What the hell are you?
You ugly.
Yeah, Predator plays a trick on him and that little cave bit.
Yep.
And then he falls in the water and all of his mud camo's gone.
Yeah.
The water removes... I've just realised the water removes Predator's invisibility. The water removes Arnie's invisibility
as well.
They
see each other.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you get the showdown. And Predator kind of realises...
Do the impression when he says, "Do it, come on."
You're good at that. "Do it now. Kill me, I'm here. Do it." Predator realises that it's just a guy, no weapons. He's like, "Right, I'll defeat you hand to hand then, because you're a worthy opponent." Takes off his mask. Imagine seeing this for the first time in the cinema.
Yeah. Because of the mandibles. Do you know whose idea it was to have mandibles?
Let somebody else do this, though.
James Cameron?
Yes, it was. Done your research, Mark.
I have, yeah.
Yeah,
sat on a plane. And
next to Sam Winston?
Sam Winston, yeah.
He said, "I've always wanted to see a creature with mandibles."
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love the idea of Sam Winston going, "Yeah, right."
Yeah.
Quickly write that down, mandibles.
It's my idea, everyone.
Yeah.
Did James Cameron direct Aliens as well?
Aliens.
Ridley Scott did Alien, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
So that may be where the crossover started to happen.
Yeah.
And in the end, it was Dark Horse Comics who got the rights to do the comics, and then the game happened. Rebellion, of course, shout out to Rebellion for that.
Yep.
And then the film eventually, which was all right.
And then he basically log falls on Predator, didn't he? And
people saying it's like, he set two traps. No, he didn't.
Yeah,
the counterweight was just part of the trap.
Yeah.
And Predator happened to jump into the where, so he wins by pure chance.
Yeah,
it's activates good. The trap, hits him,
but he starts to come up, and I think, oh god, he's still not dead. But he's just like, you got me. And then the laugh and the countdown, which you got on your tattoo.
Yeah, my tattoo there is one of those symbols.
It's a number. What number is it?
I don't know. Let's say number nine.
And he has to run away because he realises it's a bomb.
Mm.
He runs. He just gets under a...
Runs away from...
Under a ditch and survives a nuclear explosion.
Yeah. God bless him.
And another one of my favourite bits is there's no dialogue. He just gets on the chopper. No one says...
No one says a thing.
Kevin Peter Hall, maybe. Yeah, just a couple of lines, but they just look at each other and that's it.
He looks knackered as well, doesn't he, that? He's laying there like...
Fucked. Sorry, I swore again.
I would have been like, "You're not going to believe what's happened. There's an alien down there. There's an alien." Yeah. He's just like that.
Not even. I did it. I killed the bastard.
Yeah.
I guess the explosion sort of.
You never see that character that I can recall in any of the other comics, games, movies that I know of.
Right.
You never see Alan Dutch Schaefer again. His brother's in Cold War.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You never see Alan. He was thought to be brought back for The Predator, but the scene was cut, apparently. So, yeah, that's the only time.
And
the
cool ending with the credits.
Ah, yes. That's,
like,
yeah.
That's
Oddly.
Do you think you are kidding?
They all film a bit where they... special bit where they look at the camera and go... Apart from Arnie.
Yeah.
And there's nobody knows why that never happened, but he was like... They just took a bit from the film and used that.
Yeah.
But odd, isn't it?
Yeah.
Maybe
it's quite funny, isn't it?
It's too big for that.
Yeah. And that was Predator.
Mm-hmm.
Was there a computer game?
There are many computer games.
I think I had this computer game.
What did you have it on?
It must have been Commodore 64.
Commodore 64, I had it on the Commodore 64.
I can picture it now.
Terrible.
I can picture the cassette tape.
Yeah, terrible game. But used all like we had back then, wasn't it? We just, it was super hard, couldn't get through like the first screen or something like that. But again, they advertised by making games and stuff like that. Commodore 64, the Nintendo had one as well, which was rubbish. Now Predator has been in loads of other games since then. And there's been Alien vs. Predator. It's become quite successful, Alien vs. Predator. Predator Concrete Jungle was a PlayStation 2 game I had as well. But yeah, back then, I had the Commodore 64. Yeah. Took ages to load and was super hard. Died straight away. Had to reload it again. So frustrating as hell. But I have watched the YouTube of somebody completing that.
Oh, okay.
And you do actually eventually fight the Predator. But in the game, like you come down for the helicopter, you start running through the jungle, and you discover all your teammates dead and you pick up their guns. It sounds much more involved than it actually is. It's just from left to right with basic colours. But yeah, and then every now and again the screen will go blue and this red triangle will follow you. So it's very cool in that respect. But yeah,
cool, that's cool. I didn't have it.
Didn't have it?
No, didn't even have
it. You didn't have a Commodore 64?
Yes.
You did?
Commodore 64 was my first computer.
Me too.
Then the Atari 2600.
That's not a computer, that's a console.
Then Mega Drive.
Mega Drive. No Predator games on the Mega Drive. No. Oh, there's Predator 2.
Was there?
Which is rubbish.
Right. Okay. Have we got time for a quiz?
I do.
Paul?
Yeah.
Yeah. Quiz time.
Are you doing the quiz, Paul?
Yeah, come on.
I'm doing
the quiz.
Be fun.
I'll have a buzzer.
You
just some, take up space on my desk.
You get some funny answers sometimes. Right, okay. There we go. Quiz time.
Guys, so listeners, I do have a button.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, come on. Paul, how's your buzzer go? Sorry.
Well, I'm sure it works.
Yeah, go on. Mark. Scott. Look at that, eh? Okay, I have got for you, well, I've got 12 questions. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready, Paul? Come on, you can get one. If you get one, Paul, I would love it. Come on, team Paul, team Paul, all the way.
I'll try and get one.
Come on. Okay.
I mean, if you're going to ask who the main character was played by, Dutch.
Question one, finish the line, get to the... Oh, I'm only joking. Oh, it's not a question.
Helicopter.
I should say it's not helicopter, it's chopper.
You know, watch the film, Scott.
Come on, and I got the buzzer first.
That wasn't even on now, I just did that. I did that for the laughs.
Rob.
For the gig.
You crazy son of a bitch.
Okay, right. Question one. How many Jeeps drove along the beach at the beginning? Four.
Four.
Oh, three. I thought he was going to go, Scott. Did you press X? Yeah, three?
Yeah.
It was three.
I was going to say three, and I thought, no.
Imagine if he had got the first question.
Oh, no, Scott would have broken his sweat.
Scott would have gone, even in his car, drove down the road. Question two. Including Dylan, how many members were on the team? Scott just...
No, let Paul have a go.
Paul, go on then.
Seven.
He's gone!
Yay! Can you imagine that? I could have been 2-0 up.
To be like the Magnificent Seven. That's what I wanted.
Yeah. That's a guess. I was picturing five and I thought, no, there's... And then he said...
I wouldn't have got that. I'd have had to have gone through in my mind.
Yeah, I was trying to count them.
Yeah. Yeah. So that is the quiz. Well done. 1-1.
Yes.
It's a draw.
Hows, are you still here?
Yep, still here.
No, I thought you got an Amy. You're quiet.
If anyone's wondering, it is 8-3 in the overall scores.
Two.
If people are keeping count of there.
Who's got eight?
Scott.
Oh, okay.
Question three.
So if Pars wins, can I have his point?
Yeah, you can have his point if he wins.
Cheers.
Question three. What was the first line spoken by the general?
You're looking good, Dutch.
You're looking good, Dutch. Correct.
It's been a long time, General. Come inside.
Question four. What logo was on Blaine's t-shirt?
MTV.
Yeah. MTV, Scott.
Helps if I knew who Blaine was.
good one.
I should have said Commodore 64 when he came.
VH1.
Yeah.
Right, this is quite easy one, really.
Oh, good.
Question five.
I'm ready.
How many hours ago did the general say we've lost a chopper? Paul? Hello? His buzz is 12. It wasn't 12.
18.
It was 18. Question 6. What is Hawkins' first name?
Ooh.
Paul. Stephen.
Not that one.
Oh.
Sorry.
Have I got a question that no one knows?
Oh, Jesus, Scott. I just have to buzz
no,
in
I can't think he ever... he does.
I hope I'm right, anyway.
Oh, Rick, is it?
It's Rick.
Is it Rick?
It's Rick.
Where did he say that, then?
I'm not sure if he ever says it, but they don't really say any of those names.
Yeah,
they're
well,
in the script.
Their names,
they're in the script,
it's Rick.
Yeah.
Mark, well, so I found out something that I'm hoping you're going to say later on.
What is the score?
On this quiz, yeah. This quiz, it's 4 to Scott, 1 to Paul, 1 to Mark. What are we on? 7. What was Hawkins' role in the film? What was his job?
Well, he's kind of like a radio operator.
Radio operator, yeah. Well,
get
done,
Scott.
Caught
up on the hook.
Question. That one's a bit easier. See, let's
no, don't
it.
Do it. Do I might know that one. I might know that one.
Question 8 is an easy one.
Just move this.
How many skinned bodies were found up on the
paw? 2.
Oh, it wasn't 2. Who pressed next?
3.
It was 3. Well done, Mark.
Actually, I was going to say 6.
Yeah, 3 bodies. Question 9.
I actually thought that was 2.
No, definitely 3. Because there was 3 bodies hanging from the...
Oh, shit. I just remember counting 4 legs.
No. It was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Quick maths.
6 legs.
Question 9. Who imitates a bird noise, then kills one of the lookout guards?
That is Mac.
Here's Mac.
Oh, I didn't know his name. I knew which one it was. It's the one who was in Commando.
Yeah, not Blaine.
So, could I've...
What, so you're just going to tell me what films they were in?
No, but I didn't know his name.
Who was the lead role in this film? Ah, the guy from Kindergarten Cop. Yeah. Okay, if you do that in the next one, I'll give you the
I
point.
I need a little bit of help.
I'll give you the point. Come on, well, you got one. You're doing all right. Doing well.
That's how many bodies were hanging in the tree? Well, it's the number between 2 and 4.
What are we on? Question, is this 10? Yeah, I think it's 10.
Well, have a look. If you've got 3 questions left at number 10,
well, they're
12.
All over the place, so I have to sort of, question 10. What name did Matt give to the minigun?
Matt give.
Yeah, he said we better get something out of the bag.
Oh, is it not old, is it?
You're nearly there.
P, old
spice.
Dark attack number.
Oh, you were so close.
Painless.
Painless, yeah. Old painless. So I give you a point each there?
Go on.
But Blaine does call it old painless as well.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought it was Blaine, not Mac.
Yeah.
No, the first time Mac says to Blaine, should we get old painless out of the bag? Mac says it.
I look. Blaine just said just before we get shot as well.
Yes. Yep.
Oh, come on in, you fuckers.
Yeah.
Come on in. Old painless is waiting. That's it.
Question 11. Finish the line.
Oh, yes, cheers.
I hear you. This shit's something. Makes Cambodia look like
Kansas.
Kansas, yeah. Well done.
I was going to say Dick Cock.
Was that 11? I'll tell you what, let's do 13. I said 13, didn't I? Okay.
When did you say 13? You said 12.
Yeah, I've got another one. I just made it up. Dutch was played by Arnold Schwarzenegger. Spell Schwarzenegger.
Oh. Nah, I'll let you go and have a shot at that.
Ooh.
I'll give it a go then.
Go on, go for it.
Schwarzenegger.
Correct.
Way!
Well done. I don't think I'd have got that. Oh, I probably said like 1
I don't think I'd have got
G.
The 2 G's.
Yeah, 1 G, yeah.
I was looking to see if I had that up on the wall.
Twins. I should have done. I had it in the pocket.
Okay.
All right, get back to your position, Paul.
Sorry.
And the final question. Dylan and Dutch greet each other with that handshake. Paul?
Dylan, you son of a bitch.
Nope. How many seconds did that handshake go on for?
Oh, God.
18.
Incorrect. Go on, guess. Someone gets it. You can keep going. You can guess again.
15.
Incorrect.
Chef.
Scott.
12.
Incorrect. One guess each. Go on.
22.
Oh.
Right. Okay, so it's going to be 21 or 23 then.
21.
No. Scott.
23?
It's 20.
20.
Yeah, it's 20.
Okay.
So I count with it. So it, and it sort of goes off, the handshake goes off the screen button.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's around about 20. It's 20. It's 20.
I'm going to watch it back and
count it.
Ask for Stuart's inquiry.
Yeah. VAR.
Our question for you, Rob.
Got one of the quiz. Yeah, go on.
The General, what is his surname?
General.
Because this is what I thought you was going to ask me, so I read.
I don't know. Don't know.
Phillips.
General Phillips.
He's a two-star general. He had two-star caps, didn't he? But
what is...
I wrote it down on the quiz question this morning. I forgot to read it out.
Poncho's surname. It said once.
That's Chavez guy, isn't it?
Yeah. Richard Chavez. Yeah.
His surname. Ooh.
They say it once.
But no, we won't have clues for this. Sorry.
Anyone?
No.
So his surname's not Poncho?
Nope.
I thought that was his surname
or nickname.
Ah, okay.
It's Mac Elliott, isn't it?
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, didn't know.
Is that said somewhere?
No, I think I found this on doing some research. So I don't think most of these names are said, but they're right.
No, they're not. Yeah. I started looking up because they say this one, and I thought, what do they want the other guys? Get Ramirez on his feet and get to the chopper.
Ramirez on his feet,
Yeah.
I remember that line now, but I wouldn't have got it.
So those are the things I swear you were going to ask those two questions. Yeah, yeah. So I was like, right, I've got that in the bag waiting for the quiz. Right, but you didn't ask him. So.
You asked, it's 9-3 in quizzes.
Get in.
Right. Before we wrap things up, got a little gift for Mark for joining us on our last two episodes. You can open it on here. No one can see, but
open
it
now.
Tell them what it is. You can open it.
Ooh,
it's exciting.
Everyone loves unwrapping stuff, don't they?
Oh, yeah. Do you know what? This I obviously. Oh, look at that. That's lovely, that is.
You can tell everyone what it is.
I used to have this exact, well, obviously not this exact copy, but yeah, this. Yeah. So it's Predator on VHS.
This is how big a VHS box
is. Huge, isn't it?
And if you had a big collection, where you'd put all those things. We used to sacrifice so much space.
Yeah.
We just don't need to anymore.
Well, I'm collecting them all now again, so I've gone back to doing it.
Excellent.
It cost me £6 from eBay. We've signed it, or we've all signed it.
It's worth about £3
It's
now.
£3 now, yeah. That's now refaced. It's now £3. Well, I was going to get you a present for joining us in Die Hard, and I was going to get you the book, you know, the book of the film.
Yes. Oh, which
it was £25, and I thought, I ain't spending that on you.
No,
it's nice, isn't it?
You're one of my best mates, but £6, yeah.
So it shows where Scott and I are, because we got jack shit.
Yeah. So a signed picture of...
Don't feel bad.
Signed VHS, eh? That's cool, isn't it? Take that home. It's like you've been on a quiz show, isn't it? You just finished.
That's all right. You could put that next to the signed John Gorman book you got me, Paz.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Thought I signed myself.
Yeah. What?
Yes. Signed, I found this in the loft. And a guy bought me this once.
Ooh, what's this?
This is... Now, it's a copy of. It's not actually a signed script of Predator.
Oh.
But someone's bought me that for one of my birthdays.
That is cool. We'll put this on Instagram, shall we?
Yeah, but that was Rich again, my diehard guy. We could get him on one day. But
Sonny Landon.
Yeah, definitely.
So what you got? Arnold Schwarzenegger, Kevin Peter Hall, that's Jesse Ventura. That might be Sonny Landon. That's
he died, didn't he? Epidemia. When it was.
Yeah, he died recently, Sonny Landon.
Yeah.
Did you see the story that the film wouldn't get insured?
Yes.
Because they had to employ a bodyguard for Sonny.
Because he had such a bad temper.
Protect other people.
Yeah. His job was to basically just go around and say, right, don't you start anything.
Yeah.
Like that.
That's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
Something like that.
That's Epidelia, whatever her name is.
Anna's
name. I don't remember. Yeah. Bill Duke.
Bill Duke. Yeah,
and I can't tell. Carl Weathers.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Shane Black.
Yeah.
So where's. Yeah, you're right. There's no.
Unless that's it there.
It might be that there.
Yeah.
Nothing on the back. I was going to read it, but I realised it's not opened. So I was like, well, I'm not going to even open it.
Yeah.
It's a script, is it?
That is the script, yeah. The original Horde Hunter.
Yes, yeah.
Well, you think it's the script.
It might just be a front cover.
A ream of A4.
It may just be, yeah.
With a fancy cover.
Okay.
If you open that top drawer, Rob.
Yeah, sorry.
There's a half ream of A4 in there.
That's good. Going to give that to Mark as a gift, couldn't we?
Yeah.
Right, we've got some memories to read out, and we've got a couple of memories, favourite lines and that from
all around the globe.
That have sent a voice note. So, Scott.
Okay, I've got one from Bruce from Montreal, Canada. We talked about it a lot today. Anyway, what's the matter? The CIA got you pushing too many pencils with the infamous handshake from Dutch and Dylan, you son of a bitch.
Nice. Bam! Nice. Paul?
This one, well, the first one is from Martin in Salisbury. You're hit, man. You're bleeding. I ain't got time to bleed. Ah, okay. You got time to duck? Not bad.
Nice.
Good. And Dan from Texas. This stuff will make you a good damn sexual tyrannosaurus, just like me.
Nice. And Mark?
I've got one, another Martin, but this one's from the Netherlands. Classic line from
Dutch.
Billy. This is from Billy, this one. I've already said it, but...
Good one. Clever.
Sorry.
That's a bit slow.
Oh, you got it! Jesus.
I was trying to concentrate and read this.
Yeah.
There's something out there waiting for us. And it ain't no man. Nice. We're all gonna die.
Nice.
And then this is from The Night Is Round on Instagram. My favourite part of the movie is the jungle shootout scene. After all those rounds they fired, they realised they didn't kill anything.
We hit nothing.
Yeah. Again, I think that's something else that they demythed on Mythbusters. Yeah.
Yes, that's it. You're right.
They hit something.
You'd never
chop down those trees by shooting at them. Yeah.
And we've got two voice notes. Play the voice notes, Paul.
Afternoon, gents. Steve here from Abingdon. Just wanted to give you a bow and say what a top action film this was back in the day. With one of my favourite all-time supporting actors, Apollo Creed, Action Jackson, Chubbs in Happy Gilmore, Mr. Carl Weathers. One thing that I was disappointed with in the film was Billy's chest cut fight with the Predator, which we never get to see. Anyways, keep up the good work and here's to a successful 2024. By the way, I did spot Rob and Paul at Farringdon's Christmas light switch on with my 1-year-old son Jack, but decided not to approach them as they just reminded me too much of the two guys out of Home Alone. Anyway, have a good evening, gents. Take care.
Hi, three retro movie geeks. Rebecca here from Didcot. This film is amazing. It's got everything, blood, guts and fabulous one-liners. I saw this at Abingdon Cinema, although I was only 12. They weren't very strict on age classification and things back then. And my favourite one-line is when Dutch says, "You are one ugly motherfucker."
All right, thanks for that. That was Steve thinking we're the two guys from Home Alone. It must be the Wet Bandits.
I think so.
I'll be... who do you want to be? Which one do you want to be? What's the tall one? Is that Harv?
Marv.
Marv and Harry?
Yeah.
Well, thanks for that, Steve and Rebecca, for leaving us a voice note. Right, don't forget we are on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube and our website. Right. Next episode. Right, what are we going to do for our next episode... we are now, us three, going to pick a movie we want to do. Then we're going to put this as a poll on Instagram and our listeners can vote what movie we will do next. And then the one with the second vote, the one that comes second, we will then do next. And the third, we'll do after that.
Yes.
Okay, so let's build it up. Paul, we'll start on you. Your film you'd like to do for our... Episode, is it 16? I think it's 16.
No, I don't think we've done that many.
I'm sure this is 15. Anyway, go for it.
Well, if this is 15, it will be 16.
I'm sure this is 15.
So, this is one of my wife's favourite films. She doesn't watch many films. She certainly doesn't watch many films twice, three times, or even four times. So, I know I mentioned this one to you. So, my choice, and I actually grown to like this film, is The Lost Boys.
Yeah. Nice.
One of my wife's favourite films as well.
Yeah. Again, I'm
one for the ladies.
Certainly not a chick flick, but yeah. Well, mind you, Jason Patrick and...
It had sexy vampires in, didn't it? Girls back... The chicks dig it, to say an 80s phrase. Good choice.
Yeah, so my choice is Lost Boys.
Tell you what, I've watched it recently. Last couple of weeks I've watched it. Can't really remember it when I was younger. Absolutely loved it. Mm. I'm playing the soundtrack now. I've watched
the
music it. Yeah, it's really...
I've never played it. I've never watched it, really? Sorry. So I have not. Yeah. So it's one of
the... So what's your choice then, Scott? Back to the
I'm
Future
gonna
Part 2?
I'm going to go for the ladies. I'm maybe being sexist here, but one for the wife. Maybe just so you can watch it with me. Dirty Dancing.
Cool. Good one. Good choice.
A bit of a left... not That's another good Arnie action.
Yeah, we've done a lot of
them with me. Yeah. You know, I love that stuff. I'm going to go left field, Dirty Dancing.
Never seen it all the way through. Can we do the lift when we record?
We can try.
Who's lifting?
That'd be a nice sound, actually. Just like,
cut.
We could do that one in the car park. We've got plenty of room to run up.
Good choice. My one keeps changing every week. I've been thinking about what I want to do.
This is the moment.
Well, favourite ever film is Jurassic Park, but we're sticking with 80s.
We are sticking with 80s for now.
So my favourite 80s films have been The Goonies, The Gremlins, which we've done.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do The Burbs.
Mm-hmm.
But the one I'm going to do, which is one of my all-time favourite 80s films, is Never Ending Story.
Never seen it.
So I'm gonna stick that on the pile. So we've got Never Ending Story, Dirty Dancing, and The Lost Boys will be our next three.
So episode 16 is The Lost Boys. Mm.
Shoutouts. Anyone got any shoutouts?
My dad, like we said earlier, but there's no point. All right, cheers, Jeff.
Cheers, Jeff boy. Big Jeff. Mark, you got any shoutouts?
I might show a shout to Mike and Bobby, a couple of my mates to work with. Listen to the last one, Die Hard, so you never know, they might listen to this one.
Cool.
I've got two. First one, you may have heard it in the background.
Nice.
Three Retro Movie Geeks. My son, Emil, made it as his school project.
That's awesome.
And brought it home as a present for me.
That's awesome, man.
That's clever, isn't it?
Been etched out.
Put that on Instagram, shall we?
Yeah. And the second one, again, is it's Christmas present from Emil and my wife Lisa, Christmas present. So we'll probably get a picture. So behind you is three pictures of the Terminator, Gremlins, and an Ewok. So these are from Nick Gribben, illustration. He does various illustrations and goes around Comic-Cons. Check out his website, deadalloversshop.com. On Instagram is @deadallover.
Cool. They're good, aren't they? My couple of shout-outs, Andy Groom and Richie Twine, who me and Mark had a few beers with before Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
And they're going to listen to this one. Shout-out to you guys and his band, Prisoners of Katrina. Go and listen to them. Look them up. They're quite cool. And a big shout-out to Kim Ward, again, from Instagram, who gave us some really nice messages, said this is her favourite podcast.
Yay!
So thanks for that, Kim. That's it. We done?
Yeah.
We better get to the chopper. Get out of here.
Hang on, I'm just going to get my...
See what I said? It's from the film, that line.
Just going to get my pen out.
Didn't see that bit.
From the film. Right, thank you, everybody. Thanks, Mark, for joining us. You had a good time? Mark. He's had a great time, and you bloody love
it. Bloody love it, yeah.
He's loved it. see you next time on one of those films that we have chosen. What will it be? Keep it retro. Be crazy, sir. Long arms of the cat.